In today's episode, I'm going to share one of my newest obsessions, mug rugs. They're like coasters, but bigger. Great way to use your fabric scraps. Also fantastic to use the small designs across the top of the panel from my new collection, Happy at Home from Riley Blake Designs. Let's talk about what you need to make a mug rug. You can make them simple, you can make them more complicated. We're just gonna get a couple done. And mug rugs vary in size. Basically, it's an oversized coaster that you can put a mug and maybe a cookie or a little plate or biscotti or whatever you want on there. So don't fret too much about the exact dimensions of this. We're going to do this as a quilt-as-you-go project, which means we're going to quilt as we go. So instead of putting all our pieces together and then quilting, we're going to quilt one piece at a time, and I'll show you what that means. So to do quilting as we go, we need a base, and I'm going to show you three different options. The first option is you can use scraps of regular just quilt batting. But to use batting, it needs a little bit more stability to quilt right on it. So you're going to use a backer fabric as well. And muslin works great. It's thin, but it will work. You're just gonna place that right on top. And then you will put your piece on top of that. So we would put that there. We do our quilting, then we add our next piece. So that's one option. Another option is to use muslin and a fusible fleece. One of the reasons I say to use muslin is it's not gonna add a lot of bulk to your project. You can also use white fabric, white scraps, or a solid. The thing you wanna to remember about using scraps for your kind of temporary base that's gonna be on the inside of your mug rug is you wanna make sure it is not gonna show through. Say you had a scrap like this and you were doing something lighter on the back, that's gonna show through. So that's what you need to pay attention to. And then I also tried using a scrap of flexi-foam. This one is with fusible fleece. This one is with flexi-foam. You can see it gives a different look. You can really see that quilting even more distinctly on that, and it feels different. I know you can't feel it on the video, but I'm feeling it for you. It just depends the look you want. I will say doing the flexi-foam was a lot harder to get it turned under to top stitch so that you can really tell that I did it at the top. I should have done it at the bottom or the side. Didn't realize. Next time I do a foam one, I will bind it instead of doing this non-binding method. But today I just want to show you how to whip these up quickly without having to do binding. All right, let's get started. I've cut the muslin and the batting to 11 inches by 7.5 inches. You always want the quilt as you go part to be bigger so that we can trim it down to size before we sew it together and make the mug rug with no binding. That's the easiest way to do it. So then you're going to place your first design on top of the batting and the muslin. Because I'm gonna do really simple quilting on this as well, I'm gonna do straight lines, and I'm gonna use my favorite thing, painter's tape. This is 1-inch painter's tape, and I think it works great for mug rugs. So I'm just going to cut a piece, or rip a piece, that will go diagonal from corner to corner. And you can do either direction. I'm gonna go this direction. Now you don't wanna press it down on the batting because it'll really stick on the batting and then it's a mess to pick up. But we're just going to use this as a guide. I'm gonna sew down either side and I'm just gonna keep moving the tape, and I'm going to get perfectly parallel lines, super fast, super easy. So that's the first thing we're gonna do. We're just gonna take a sewing machine, and we're gonna sew all that quilting. And you don't need to worry about knotting when you start and stop your quilting because the edges are all going to be trimmed a little bit in the end. So you can just start and go for it. Once you sew on both sides of the tape, your initial time, you're just going to keep lifting the tape off of your mug rug and then lining it up on the other side of one of those stitch lines and then stitching to the side that doesn't have any stitching. The main thing to remember is do not stitch through your tape or it will be a mess to pick up and move for the next one. All right, so we have our Let's Stay Home square quilted on there. And this is our plan. We're gonna have the blue dot over here, and then we're gonna have the birds from the selvage right there. So the next step is going to be to sew this blue on here. So we're just going to flip it and we're going to line up the edge of the blue and the edge of that square. And you'll notice I'm not worried about how long this is. It's longer than the rest of it because it's all getting trimmed at the end. Sewing this one on, and then we will flip and press that. So next we're gonna add our birds. So I am gonna trim this a little bit just because it is kind of long. And then I need to decide how much of this brown I want showing. I'm going to put this raw edge slightly over this seam because I don't want this seam to show. I want it to look like we have pieced these three things together. So it's going to be just over that seam, and I'm going to sew down there with a quarter inch. All right, that's going to look good. Let me go quick press that. I forgot to do the quilting on the dots, so I'm just going to fold that back down. No worries. See, this is one thing I love about these. It's just kind of a free-for-all of whatever you decide is fun. So I'm going to do lines so they'll be horizontal. So I'll have just some different variety of lines on this mug rug. So I'm going to take this piece of tape again. I'm going to just shorten it. And I'm going to center that. I'm going to sew on either side. And I moved this back so that I can knot in here and we won't see where this line ends. Now you don't want your tape to go too far over your fabric because you don't want it to stick onto your sewing machine while you're doing this quilting. Now we have that quilted. So now the last part is just deciding how I want to quilt this selvage on here. We're getting close. Now it is time to trim our quilted front and match it to the back. The back is already pre-cut to 7 inches by 10 inches, which is going to give us a 9.5 by 6.5 mug rug. I'm just going to line up these edges on the grid lines because it's really up here that really needs to be cut. And then I am going to trim and make this a nice little rectangle. So just keep lining everything up unless you're going to be using a rotating mat, which I'm obviously not at the moment, and get it all squared up. And then we're gonna trim the back to fit the front because I think my front is going to end up being a little bit smaller. See how I'm lining this up along that straight edge as well. Now you're gonna put right sides together, the front and the back, and well, you'll see we have this one sizes a little bit different. So our mug rug is a little bit long. So I'm going to turn it over and I'm going to trim the backing so that our front and back are the same size. I've sewn around the three sides and now we need to clip the corner. So here's what I recommend for clipping corners. Instead of just clipping straight across like that, making a triangle, come down the sides and come up to that point. Do not clip your stitching, very important. But this is going to take a lot more of the bulk out of that corner and it's going to make it easier to turn and get a nice corner for there. Now we've left this edge completely open. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn this right side out. I always use my fingers to get those corners out as best I can to begin with. And then grab my cute little bird, Riley Blake Turner, to get that corner turned out even better. You want to do it gently because if you go with too much force, sometimes the blue point comes out and you have pushed through your stitching. If that happens, you can just turn it back the other way and re-sew that, but it's preferable not to do that. Okay, so I got those corners out. Now I'm going to go press it and I'm going to fold this end under on both sides and then we're gonna come back and we're going to top stitch. Now we're gonna top stitch all the way around, which is going to give us a nice finish on the outside and it is going to close the open section and nobody will know where it was.
So what do you think? Are you sold on mug rugs? Have you ever tried them before? They're great for gifts, teacher appreciation, Secret Santa for your neighbors, for coworkers. These would be a wonderful thing to sew and sell at craft fairs. I'd love to know what you think of this and how you might use this project in your sewing life. Leave me a comment and let me know.